Metro.
2033 is the latest Russian book I am diving on into, as you can tell by the number of consonants in the author's name, and I've been really excited to read this once again. It turns out I at least started it probably like over a decade ago, and I realized that while I was going ahead and flipping on through this read, and I don't know how I felt about it last time, but this time I think I'm going to have an unpopular opinion because, well, let's talk about what this book does right first. First, atmosphere. The atmosphere of this book is some of the best I have read in recent memory. There is quite a bit of time spent in these underground metro tunnels, and God, each and every step of this journey through them is just bleeding with personality. The treatment of these tunnels reminded me of Master and Commander and how it treats the ship within those books as an actual character. The same effort is paid to just the living, breathing landscape around our main character. I drank that up, and it became probably the most compelling factor through the book. Really, what I wanted to keep reading for was just this insane level of atmosphere the author manages to achieve. And a post-apocalyptic atmosphere that's well done is going to be some big old meaty hooks in me. And I also really like the setting of this book, because it's not what you standardly get with apocalyptic dystopian sci-fi. Usually you have like the last remnants of humanity struggling to find food and just make it to the next day. Here in Metro 2033, it's much more of a, we've gotten to a point where we're stable. There is civilizations in contact with each other. There is some stability. And so it's like the horrible things happened, everything's irradiated, but we've recovered a bit. Like, that's where we're standing at. And another strength of the setting was watching these various factions at play, and they're struggling to establish communication with each other, and that's actually one of the main driving threads of the narrative. Any narrative that has like a communication element should hook me, but we'll get into why it doesn't necessarily in a minute. But it was such an intelligent choice to move this society to a point where it does have some of these stable elements, so that then you could focus on actually kind of getting into the wider situation around these people and the threats they face now that they aren't just like always on the brink of extinction. The problem is a new threat arises in the Dark Ones. And I was expecting more from these Dark Ones, but in typical Russian nihilistic view on humanity literature approach, they aren't really the main conflict throughout most of the story. And that's actually a choice I, in premise, like. I love when there's some evil monsters, but narratively the focus goes into the evil within us. I like that. It's been done a lot, but if it's still done well, I can enjoy it. And I did enjoy it here to a point. Now let's get into the first big criticism I have, and that's going to be the narrative structure of this book. I really enjoyed the first third, as this world that is so bleak is painted before me with these glimmerings of hope and rebuilding. I was so invested. And then there is an initiating incident involving these Dark Ones that sends our main protagonist, Artyom, on his journey through the tunnels. And for a little while, the tunnels were enough to completely just pull me through. And in fact, in the segments of the book where we're really just experiencing the environment, I was still hooked all the way to the last third. But the actual events that occur within this second third, I found rather boring. Actually to the point where they felt redundant, because we're kind of coming across these different cults, and the author's messaging of his views of religion and people, it's a combination of it's either been done so much that I'm getting nothing new from it, or he's heavy-handed to the point where even if I agree with him in some of his points, it's highly obnoxious. I did not expect subtlety going into a post-apocalyptic Russian book, but the lack of it was genuinely jarring. This is a blunt book. After recording my review and doing some research into criticisms Metro 2033 has faced, I want to make sure what I'm saying here is not mistaken for me agreeing with actually a fairly common criticism that this book is
overly descriptive, overly detailed. I really liked that, and I think it was in great service to the atmosphere and making the horror land. Specifically, I'm saying there is too much redundancy in the narrative tie-ins to the overall theme. The fact that our main character has multiple run-ins with cults that are largely, like, yes, they have different ideologies or different cults, but it's the same critique of the people, in my opinion, again and again. There's just a lack of subtlety in that element that I found to be very cancerous to my overall enjoyment of the immersion of the book, because the author's voice of telling me what he thinks became louder than the experience of the novel. So there's a fine line there, but I want to really draw it because I personally really love the descriptions here, and there are more themes that go deeper and beyond what I'm talking about. I'm just specifically saying for this one through line of theming, it was too blunt for me. There are other ones that are more subtle and in the background, but they're certainly not the main flagship philosophy, and that's where the problems came in.
And if you combine a lack of nuance with the themes covered with rather redundant and just time-consuming, it almost just feels like the authors wanted to bloat the page count. It really started to drag Metro 2033 for me down. Luckily, the ending where Artyom, without getting into spoilers, manages to reach a place where he is trying to accomplish his mission and is working with other people, it really transformed and began to interest me again in some ways outside of just the setting. But with my overall lack of interest in the main character, there was nothing the book could have done at that point to bring it up to like a high glowing review for me. Because on the character level, I found this to be one of the most failing books I've read recently. I do not care about literally anyone in these pages. They do not really go through magnificent arcs. Their observations are not super insightful. And the meat of the character that's already there was rather lean. And I really wanted some more fat. Which sucks, because if you had just taken away some of these narrative beats that just did not need to be there to land home the messaging that was already quite clear, and instead took the time to flesh out the character within the pages, I feel like this could have been a lot better. As it sits though, I enjoyed the game more than the book, which is actually something I have never said before. I liked the game quite a bit. I actually off stream played it quite a lot with a friend of mine, and it was a blast. It's quite the atmospheric fun shooter that once again narratively didn't hook me so much, but because of the difference of medium, I could still enjoy the pop, 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 pop. You can't really do that here because there isn't really like spectacularly written action. It's just fine. I will end on a positive though, and that's the actual pros. The pros here are, as you can probably guess from my praise of the atmosphere and the descriptions, fantastic. And I don't believe the translation from Russian to English from my brief research into it actually is that bad. So if you are interested in this premise enough to forgive some rather just handling of the ideas covered and a lack of character, I could see this being some people's, you know, up in upper echelon of sci-fi dystopias. But for me, with a lack of characters to interest me and a narrative that I could just lift out a middle third from and not really feel it missing, I can't really give this above a 6 out of 10. It's one of those really frustrating reviews though, as a critic, where I know on a technical level, this book is impressive, and it's unfortunately been hurt by other things coming after it, doing a lot of the things accomplished here better, and even before it. And I know some people do not mind that at all and think that shouldn't be weighed into review. I personally do myself, and if you don't, fantastic. But with so many books to read in the world, and this book not really bringing too much unique to the table, unfortunately, this is mostly going to be a pass for me when it comes to recommendations. And a bit of information I want to start including in book reviews is time to read. I think this is a solid week read for most people. I got through it in about a weekend when I was just taking a brief break from One Piece. But for most people's non-psychotic reading levels, I would say this is probably a week read. 7 days! But let me know what you thought of Metro 2033, the book or the games inspired of it, in the comments down below. This is genuinely the first time I have ever said, play the game over the book. Oh my god. But anyway, y'all, like and subscribe if you have not already. Hit the Patreon if you want to support what I do here. Have a good one, y'all. Peace.